Today I'm going to be baking this Marie Callender's Cherry Crunch Pie. I looked for it at Walmart and they didn't have it, and I looked at a couple of other places. I finally found it at Meijer. It was $6.79. And then I looked at Kroger and they actually had it, and it was, I think, $8 something. So Meijer was definitely a lot cheaper. Kendra asked us to bake this and review it and see what we thought about it. I don't know if she's actually eaten it or not, but she wanted to see what we thought. So, I'll give you the details. If you cut it in 10 pieces, it is 360 calories a piece. And it's a frozen pie. You keep it frozen until you're going to bake it. It's extra flaky crust made from scratch. It is almost 3 pounds. It's very, very heavy. And that's how it looks. It has some juice on it. There must be a little bit of a leak for it to be that color. Okay, it says preheat oven to 400. I've done that. Remove plastic wrapper from the pie. Set the crumb topping aside on the counter. So we're not going to do anything with the crumb topping. Bake pie on cookie sheet in center oven for 40 to 45 minutes. So that's what I'm going to do right now. And we'll get the rest of the instructions when it comes out. So we're going to take this off.
I wonder if they have a pecan pie.
I think they have pecan, apple.
Well, if this is good, we'll have to do pecan next because I love pecan.
Daddy likes pecan pie too. So, okay. So I'm going to put this on my cookie sheet.
It's pretty thick.
It's very thick. We're going to put it in the oven for 40 minutes and I'll be back. Okay, it's been 40 minutes and, oh, this is how it looks. I'm going to lay it right here. Okay, now. The next set of instructions says to crumble the topping while it's still in the bag to the desired crumb size. And it's actually crumbled pretty good. And it says sprinkle onto pie, starting at the edge and working towards the center. Use a fork to evenly distribute the crumbs. So it does not say to do this, but I'm going to do this to make it easier on me. I am going to pour it into a bowl so that I don't make a mess getting it out of this bag. That's just me.
Looks like brown sugar.
It does look like brown sugar. Okay, now it says to put it in the oven for an additional 10 minutes. So I dropped some on my cookie sheet. I wanted to get it off there. Okay, so it says put it in the oven for an additional 10 minutes and then take it out. So that's what I'm going to do and we'll be back. Okay, 10 minutes is up. So I'm going to turn my oven off. Oh, and it looks really good. Really good. So, you are supposed to let this sit. They would like for you to let it sit for 2 hours to cool. So, I do not know how long I will let it sit. They say on the box that the pie will slice and serve most easily when cooled, at least 2 hours. So, I might try to wait 2 hours. We'll see. I'll let you know. It's 6:30 now, so I'll let you know how long I actually was able to wait for. Okay, it's been an hour. I think I've waited long enough.
You can't wait no more.
Can't wait any longer. It smells really good. And you're supposed to get 10 slices out of this. So normally we get...
8.
Yeah. Yeah, normally...
I can't imagine 10. Well, I guess
I can't imagine 10 either.
Yeah, if you'd wait a little bit longer, it wouldn't be quite as runny.
Well, right now the top is more crumbly than I expected. I'm used to the apple pie, I guess, where it's already on there. Yeah. I've never had to add the crumbles afterwards.
No, I've never seen that one.
And so...
We'll see how this works.
Yeah, I have a... Yeah, I think I'm going to pause for 1 minute. Okay.
You've got the specialized instrument.
A special tool. And it's still... might fall apart. That's okay. You know what?
Just scoop out some of that goodness there. And
there we go.
That's perfect.
There's Kevin's piece. Yeah, it's definitely runny.
Yeah, I think if you let it set, it would be a lot
better. Think so?
Oh, yeah.
I don't know. I don't know if it would be that much better or not. Okay. So, let me get the camera situated, and that's okay, I'll get us both.
Okay.
Kevin's saying I should have waited the full 2 hours. I waited an hour. I felt like that was long enough.
It would have just thickened up more. I don't care who'd be there running on the plate. There's some tart cherries.
But they're whole cherries.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like the little pieces. I mean, all the cherries in there are like full size cherries. I think that's really good. I don't know that I've ever had a cherry pie.
If I have, it's been at a family reunion or something.
It's
good. They're pretty tart.
Mm-hmm.
It's not an overly sweet pie, that's for sure.
No. No.
Matter of fact, if it wasn't for the crumble on top, I don't know that I could eat it.
If it weren't for the crumble on top, it wouldn't be any good.
No, it'd be so sour.
It would be sour.
It's pretty good. I've almost eaten my whole piece.
Like every pie that I've ever had, the crust is my favorite part. Oh, and of course, the edge, I'll save that till last. But that's any pie. I like this a lot. I don't know that I would buy it again because there's just, my favorite is apple. So I would probably get apple again because it's my favorite. And pecan pie. Ashley said if they make a pecan pie, we need to try the pecan pie.
This brand?
Yeah, she said see if they have a Marie Callender pecan pie. I don't know if they do or not, but we'll have to look for that. So because Kevin and Ashley both love pecan pie, and I do too.
Mine's gone.
Yeah, Kendra, if you're watching, you can see Kevin liked the pie. It's very good.
I like cherry, and these are, and it says on the box, they're tart. It says made with tart red cherries. So they definitely have a tartness to them, a sourness to them. Again, if it wasn't for that crumble, I don't think you could eat it. It would be so tart. That crumble's excellent. I could eat that. Just give me a spoon and eat crumble all day long.
Yeah, that's good.
That crumble's awesome. Mm-hmm. The crust on the back doesn't have as much flavor as the crumble does. The crumble is really, really good. The crust is good, but it doesn't have a ton of flavor. It's just crispy. Overall good. I don't know that, again, I don't know if I would buy it either. I would rather have like a pecan or pumpkin or something over cherry. Banana cream pie, that kind of stuff. So.
If you had the crumble and the juice, even.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. No.
It's good, though. If you like cherries, go buy it. I don't think you'll go wrong with it.
No, and I'm glad you got us to try it. Mm-hmm. So,
oh, yeah.
Hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for watching.